Tim Bontemps, who started off the playoffs saying the Toronto Raptors are going to win the NBA title. Mm. So
get
good for your
congratulations.
Once in a while. All right.
Absolutely.
Nice. I like this.
Hey. Great. You have covered the Raptors a lot this year. What do you think is the significance of them winning the first title in their franchise history?
We were kind of just talking about it, right? Everything that happened over the past few days is so crazy. It's kind of hard for me to process, really, what just happened. Mm-hmm. You know, not only does Toronto win their first championship, we have two of the best three players who are going to be free agents this summer go down for maybe all the next season, right? But just focusing on the Raptors for a second, I think it's just a pretty incredible accomplishment for so many of these guys. We were talking in the break about Kyle Lowry, you know, a guy who's gone through a lot of ups and downs in the playoffs, winning a championship. Serge Ibaka has been close a couple times. Marcus Gasol has been close a couple times. Mm-hmm. You know, they have a lot of veteran guys who fought for a long time to get to this point. It's neat to see guys who fight, you know, and go through a lot of adversity to get to the mountaintop and win a title like this.
I agree with you. I think this is everything to me. Not only for just the city of Toronto, but I'm talking about for the country. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm a first goal. I got to give more credit to the front office of Toronto. Like, you just got to, because they made some real tough decisions and it turned out well. And I also got to give major props to Kawhi Leonard, who took a lot of heat last year, not only from the Spurs, from the fans, from his teammates, but it turned out great for him far as how he went about it and set out last year. And then, in my opinion, much love to Kyle Lowry. I mean, man takes a lot of heat. And I think with him winning the championship, in my opinion, he goes down right now as probably the greatest Raptor of all time.
So you got a chance to be in the Hall of Fame?
Yes, I think so.
I think we have to see. I'm happy to say his career is not done yet. No. What I think Kyle Lowry is a great example of, by the way, is that people told him earlier in his career, hey, you need to change. You're so talented. You're so smart. You need to change these things. And I have seen athletes in this league too proud or too set in their ways. I don't have to listen to you. I'm going to do it my way.
Right.
And Kyle is smart enough and receptive enough that he took advice from people like Chauncey Billups. He took advice from coaches and other people along the way. As he said in our interview the other day, he matured. He grew up from being 20 years old to being his age now. And that's what got him there. And those kinds of decisions and sacrifices are so impressive to me. I also want to give a shout, by the way. This was a very global team that won, right? You have an African front office, but also on the team, right? You're talking about Serge Ibaka.
The wild African
segment,
from Congo.
Right? Pascal Siakam walking
around with
the
exactly. Right. You had several
Zaire
of those
with
flags.
The Nigerian flag.
Exactly.
Yep.
So I think that this will continue to have an influence on the game's growth in Africa and, of course, Canada, which is no small thing.
And also, hey, shout out to Nick Nurse and his coaching staff. Because
absolutely.
I think, you know, they did a great job of mixing it up.
Yep.
Nick Nurse wasn't scared at all. He did things that we haven't seen done in a long time or ever. He ran boxing ones and he stuck to what he believed in.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And you got to give him credit. As a first-year coach, I thought he made adjustments after adjustments. Down 0-2 to Milwaukee. He come back, he make adjustments. They win the series. It's just I can't give enough credit to him and his coaching staff, man. And they were really great, and they played a major part in this.
If you go back to August, from August forward, when they made the Kawhi trade, this team has been locked in on trying to win a title. Everything they've done. Nick Nurse experimented all season with different lineups to get this team ready for the playoffs. They rested Kawhi Leonard on the load management plan. He said to you last week, you know, he wouldn't have been here playing like this before that. They make the Marcus Gasol trade at the deadline, go, you know, move a couple key pieces. Guys who've been there for a long time, Jonas Valanciunas and DeLon Wright, to get, you know, a piece that really helped them beat the Sixers, right? If it's not for him, they don't stop Joel Embiid. They don't win that series. So, you know, time and again, you see as this year played out, the stuff that the Raptors did really paid off here.
Right. And also two things I like to add. One is, just think about this, okay? Siakam didn't even play really last year under Dwayne.
He wasn't even supposed to start necessarily. Start training camp.
Right, under Dwayne Casey. Mm-hmm. Nick Nurse had full confidence in him. And now he's about to get Most Improved Player of the Year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I was very critical of Van Fleet to start the playoffs. I thought he was horrible. I didn't know he was going through having another baby with the traveling. Nick Nurse stuck with him.
Mm-hmm.
He stuck with him. He believed in him. And Van Fleet came through for him in the clutch. And, I mean, you just got to give all the credit to Toronto.
Yeah. Nick Nurse, when I was talking to him after the win last night, he showed me one of those rubber band bracelets that he has. And it's off of a speech that he gave to the team the first day of training camp, and he talked to them about April, May, and June. He goes, the rest of the season is just going to be prepared for April, May, and June. And the rubber bracelet just says AMJ. He's been wearing it since the beginning of training camp. AMJ, and in June, he won the NBA title. That's pretty cool. I do want to get back to Kawhi Leonard, though, because, look, we've been talking about his potential free agency all season. Kendrick, do you think winning this title makes him more or less likely to stay with Toronto?
If I'm Kawhi, I know LA is his, he want to go back to his hometown, and the Clippers would be a great destination for him, and Doc Rivers is a great coach. I love him to death. But he still wouldn't be the biggest star. LeBron James would still be the biggest star in LA. And Kawhi just did something. He just won the first championship for Toronto ever in history. And not only is he going to be embraced by the city of Toronto, but we're talking about a country. They already didn't get talking about giving him the world. So if I'm Kawhi Leonard, I don't leave, because I see this team, you know, for 3 years, they could have a nice 3 to 4 year run with this team that they have right now, this core of guys that they have right now. So if I'm Kawhi, I think I stay in Toronto and just stay put.
The fascinating thing to me about this is Kawhi Leonard to me is now the kingmaker of this summer. You go back a week ago, we talked about him, Klay Thompson, and Kevin Durant, in my opinion, were the three best free agents. You know, we just said Klay's out probably all next year. Kevin's probably out all next year. You look at the way the league is set up. If Kawhi does go to the Clippers, I think the Clippers become the favorites to make the NBA Finals next year.
I agree.
If he stays with the Raptors, they are very arguably the favorites to get back to the NBA Finals again next year. He, in my opinion, he could be right now the most important player in the league, because what he decides to do could very well decide where we are at, you know, this time next year and who's playing in the finals.
Now, Toronto can offer him the most money, although by pushing his way out of San Antonio, he showed that he wasn't most concerned with that, because San Antonio back then is who could have really offered him the most money. I will point out, though, that they have the Kawhine and Dine program all over Toronto, so the man would never have to pay for a meal again. He's been offered free apartments if he stayed. I'm just saying, there's a lot going on if he does want to stay.
The whole country.